Welcome to this episode of
Tell Us About Islam.
I'm Yusuf Estes, your host, and with us today we have
Zia,
Aisha,
Fatima,
Hassan,
Rutab, and
Faizan.
It's nice to have all of you with us today on Tell Us About Islam. And I think what we'll do, we'll let you ask the first question. What would you like?
Tell us about zikr.
Zikr? You want to know about zikr?
Yes.
Zikr, well, it's an Arabic word, and it's pronounced zikr, but some people pronounce it how?
Zikr.
Zikr, right. And then what does it mean? It means to keep something in your mind. But in Islam, we mean to keep it in our mind and in our heart at the same time. To remember Allah in all that we do. We know that Allah always sees us, all the time. He's seeing us right now while we're doing our program. And He hears us all the time. He's hearing us right now what we're doing. And He even knows what we're thinking. Exactly what you're thinking. That is because He is Allah. But we have a tendency to think about a lot of things. Oh, you're thinking about some friends. You're thinking about some toys. You're thinking about food. You're thinking about going home. Thinking about doing such and such. Maybe you're going to look at something on the internet or write us some paper about something. So this is what you're thinking about. Because Allah is not like us. He can do everything at the same time. Everything. Amazing, huh? So what we're supposed to do as Muslims is to try to remember about Allah as much as we can all day so that we won't be in trouble with Allah later. Because if we forget about Allah, we're liable to do anything. But if we think about Allah, that's good for us. Now, usually if we're having a good time, playing, having fun, we're not thinking about Allah. We're really not. And usually, whenever we're having a hard time, something's really bothering us a lot, then we think about Allah. Even some people, they don't know about Islam, but they believe there's a God, they believe in some God, then they will think about their God or what they believe, but only at the time when they got a problem. When they don't have a problem, forget about it, right? But for us, we're supposed to think about it all the time. Whether we're excited and happy, or if we're afraid, or if we're sad, we still should be remembering Allah. This is a part of being a good Muslim. Another thing that we have that is called dhikr, it's called dhikr, but we recite it all the time. What is it?
Quran.
Quran, exactly. The Quran means the recitation. But when we recite it, we're actually doing dhikr. Reciting Quran is dhikr. When you say, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem, then we begin to recite. Like, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, then this is reciting Quran, and all of this, Allah likes it. He likes it, and we're thinking about Allah. What about if we get angry? One time, a man, he came to the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and he said, give me some advice. What do you think he told him?
La taghdab.
Exactly. This is meaning, don't get angry. Because when you get angry, you will forget Allah. You do. If you get really angry, you don't think about Allah. You just think about your anger, what you're upset about. You're angry. And he told him, La taghdab. So the man said, okay, what else? Give me some more advice. What do you think he said? La taghdab. The same thing. He said, and more advice. He said, La taghdab. La taghdab. He kept saying that. Don't get angry. Don't get angry. Don't get angry. It's easy to say that, but how do you get over it? If I'm angry, and you just walk up and say, don't be angry, maybe I'll get more angry. Don't tell me what to do. You know, people do that. You tell them, oh, don't be angry. What do you mean, don't be angry? I'm not angry. No, but you look angry. I'm not angry. You know? So, what can I do, though, if I'm angry? The Prophet, peace be upon him, told us something. He said, if you become angry and you're standing up, sit down. That's a good advice. And if you're sitting down, and you're angry, you could lay down, just relax. Or you can get up and go make wudu. Because when you put cold water on you, it takes away the anger. Do you know why? Do you remember in one of our programs, we talked about the jinn? Remember the jinn? Yeah. And they're made out of what?
Fire.
They're made out of fire. And did you know when you get angry, it's actually some of the jinn are bothering you? They want you to be angry. And that's why you feel heat. You feel a lot of heat. Some people even say, I'm hot. Don't bother me. I'm hot. But it's not even hot. It could be cold weather, but they say I'm hot because of their anger. This heat, this anger, is very much related to this kind of forgetting Allah. The opposite. And when I was in Egypt, I saw this sign. It said, La tansa zikrullah. La means what? It means no. Yeah, La means no. And tansa means forget. Zikr, remember Allah. Don't forget to remember Allah. That's what it says. It sounds funny. Don't forget to remember. But actually what it means is, don't forget to keep the remembrance of Allah in your mind. And when you keep your remembrance of Allah in your mind, you also will find the remembrance of Allah in your heart. We don't say you put Allah in your heart, but you do have the remembrance of Allah in your heart. It's very important. Because Allah told us in the Quran, in Surah Ra'd. What surah is Ra'd?
13.
13? Yeah, Surah Ra'd, verse number 28, exactly. What is it that Allah says? Verily, in the remembrance of Allah,
the hearts find peace
or rest. Yeah, because sometimes when we get really upset, our heart is upset. Our heart is really pumping a lot. You know, even though we're just sitting there, but you get angry, all of a sudden your heart starts pumping faster and faster. You're not running, you're not doing anything. Why is your heart going so fast? Because you're angry. And when you get angry, you don't have the remembrance of Allah. And so the heart's not at peace. It's boom, 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 boom. Faster, faster. To calm down, water, and the water does what? You cool down, and the heat of the shaitan, the devil, is off of you. Take a deep breath, relax, and you see, it makes a big difference for all of us. Now, another thing about zikr is that anybody can do it. It's not expensive, you don't have to pay any money, and you can do it any time. It doesn't matter where you are, you can remember Allah. Now, some things we do out loud, it would make us remember Allah. Like when we recite the Quran, we said Quran is dhikr. It is the dhikr of Allah, without a doubt. But how do we recite it? We say, A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim. We begin reciting the Quran after that. As long as you're reciting the Quran, then you're thinking about Allah. And what's good is, Allah likes that. And He says that even if you forget something while you're reciting the Quran, Allah will forgive you for it. Maybe you were supposed to do something else, but you forgot. You were so busy reciting the Quran, but Allah likes that, and He will forgive you. So this is how important it is for us. Recite the Quran as much as you can. I recommend for my children to start every morning. As soon as you wake up, make wudu, do your salah, and then read the Quran. It's so nice to read the Quran in the morning. It's so quiet, it's so peaceful. Nobody's out honking their horn yet, making a lot of noise. It's still nice, you know. Now if you wake up before time for salah, maybe it's only 20 minutes, 15 minutes before the salah, you can still wake up, wash, wudu, and pray two rak'ah, not for fajr, just because it's nice to pray. Because guess what? In salah is praying and prostrating on the ground and then sitting. All of that is making your body also join you in the dhikr. Now the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he told us that our body has rights. He told us our